This is TWiT.
As they say, don't try this at home. I couldn't resist, mostly because I had a laptop that had not yet been updated to version 12. And I thought, okay, if they're going to fix this after, I don't mean a laptop, an iPad. If they're going to fix this in version 12, which just became available, I want to know that it wasn't fixed in 11 point whatever I had before. So this is known as Safari Ripper. It is an Apple Safari vulnerability that quickly crashes iOS and Mac devices, where links are handled by Safari. And it works. I clicked the link, pow. It just completely collapsed the iPad. Then I updated to version 12, did it again, whoops, screen went black. And it rebooted and had to come back to life. So Apple has a problem that they did not fix in the most recent update to iOS. It exists before and it exists today. It leverages a relatively new and processor-intensive feature of CSS, cascading style sheets, which is known as the backdrop filter. That uses 3D acceleration to process the image background underlying CSS elements. The backdrop filter is able to blur or color shift regions behind an element. And you can imagine we see it on web pages often, fancy pages where you move over something or you scroll up and something that you're sort of not supposed to be paying attention to blurs, or you have a full color picture and it goes to black and white, or it goes to sort of like a chroma keyed effect. You can do all kinds of things with it, but this is actually happening not with code, but with code driven by static CSS elements, and in this case, this implementation of a backdrop filter. So the point is, it's image processing happening merely by a declaration of a line of CSS. So security researcher Sabri Hadoush was poking around while looking for reliable denial of service bugs against various browsers, when he discovered this, a simple way to essentially bring any Safari-based system to its knees. All he used was nested divs. The div is short for division, and so you can have a division in a division in a division in a division. And in fact, I looked at his code and he's got, I didn't count them, but he's like hundreds. And the problem is, if you were to apply the backdrop filter to the CSS for the division, then you're going to cascade the need to perform this rendering. That is, you're essentially layering hundreds of these filters on top of each other, and the result of that you're going to see on the top layer is the result of it's filtering through the CSS for it, which it doesn't get until it knows what the CSS behind it is going to resolve to, which it doesn't know until the CSS behind it is going to resolve to, which you're able to force with this crazy stacked set of divs in CSS and in the HTML. So it turns out, boy, is it potent. If for anyone who's interested, I have the link in the show notes. You might be able just to Google Safari Ripper right now and find it. It was not easy for me to discover it. I mean, not difficult for me to discover it. It was easy. And I mean, it doesn't do any harm, but it does immediately crash your Safari, your Safari-based rendering, whether on iOS or Mac. And I wouldn't be surprised if the link ends up getting retweeted and, you know, and so forth, people playing games with this. As I mentioned, version 12 doesn't fix this. So I would imagine that it won't be long before we get a 12.0.0.1 that does somehow arrange to resolve this.
And that only works in the Safari browser, is that right? We've got some folks in the chat room who are saying 403 forbidden on that link. I know I tried it earlier, but I wasn't on a Safari browser, and I got the 403 forbidden link. But does that mean that they bottled it up, or what does that mean at this point?
Okay, I just tried it, and it came up.
Oh,
so
okay.
Although it came up on, it came up on Firefox, which is my default renderer on Windows, and it looks just fine, and it says triggered. Which is, I know what the image is supposed to look like. So
yeah, I get a forbidden. Yeah. Strange. I get a 403. Yeah.
Anyway, so, maybe it's been taken down. It's certainly on the net and around. And in fact, I've got it on my browser. So
yeah.
Who knows?